We are here at Port Aransas, Texas coast, down the beach, 7:40 in the morning. No one here. I mean, maybe a couple of people. The goal this morning, we're gonna put some lines out in the water, show you some rigs I'm using, see what we can catch. We got an hour and a half to fish before the kids wake up. Let's see what we can do. What kind of gear am I using? I'm using this. This is a 10-foot surf fishing rod. It's called a Sea Lion. It's pretty much your entry-level rod, I would say. I got it from Cabela's online, I think around $150. When I first started looking at saltwater fishing gear, it can be really intimidating. And people are talking about $600-$700 reels and rods. And, you know, for the dad like me, who maybe only comes out a few times a year, I'm not really that big into fishing. I didn't know if buying a $150 rod would work. Would it be a waste of money, waste of time? It's actually been pretty awesome, yeah. Definitely works for me, for all you weekend warrior dads who just want to get out here and have some fun and relax on the waves. You know, this rod's been absolutely amazing. I've been catching fish all week out here, so I highly recommend it. I'm gonna set it up with a Carolina rig. So, all right, the way I have my pole rigged up today is I've got a 6-ounce Sputnik weight that's gonna help really stabilize your line out there in the waves and the surf. I've been getting away on the lighter days with a 4-ounce kind of pyramid weight. It'd be just fine, you can get nice tension and keep your line out there. But it looks a little rougher, and just to be sure, I'm gonna put the 6-inch Sputnik that'll really dig into the sand and keep your line there so you can hold it taut and really see if you're getting any bites on your line. And I actually have this set up with, this is a kind of pre-made metal high-low leader. But what I've done is I've kind of hybridized it, and instead of using it a high-low with the weight on the bottom and two hooks above, I've actually put the weight at the top. I kind of made it into a hybrid Carolina rig where you have your weight that's gonna sit in the sand, and then your line and your hook and bait are gonna float in the Carolina rig. I'm gonna hook this up. This is on 30-pound braid, and this rod I find I can cast much farther than my line with 50-pound mono. So I'm gonna load this up with maybe a huge chunk of squid, like a real oversized bait. And I'm gonna go deep with this and just let this big weight sit far out on the surf with a huge chunk of squid and see if we get something big maybe comes out there. And we're gonna see what happens. So I'm gonna cast this one out first and we'll just get started. Now, to keep your line, your pole in the sand, there's all kinds of different stands. You can buy these pole holders, you can buy those, I don't even know all the names because I started looking at them, they were expensive and just seemed like a waste of time. I've always got a lot of projects over there at the old homestead, so what I did have was plenty of, you know, 2.5, 2-inch PVC tubing, and I had like a 4 or 5 foot piece. I just got the old saw out, you see that, and I just cut myself a nice little edge. You can put this in the sand, you can wiggle it down. I probably hand force, I can easily put this down in the wet sand, 1.5 feet in, it's rock solid. Sometimes, depending on the sand, I have a hammer and I can hammer it down. I have like a wood block, I don't see it here. I have like a wood block that I'll hold, and I'll use a hammer so I don't destroy the PVC, and I'll hammer it down that way. But honestly, I found I can just twist it down in the sand and really lock it in. So I'm gonna use that. I usually put it, you know, ankle deep in the surf just to get a little bit further out there. And I'm gonna cast it out as far as we can go, and I'll let you see how it goes. On this one, like I said, put some squid. That's like a real gnarly big old chunk of, so this is frozen squid bait right from the 7-Eleven. Just near the beach where I come out. So, big gnarly wad. I'm gonna put that out in the water. Let's see what happens. Spread of lost composure. true high-low. I have my way to the bottom, and I'm gonna run shrimp on this one, and I've been catching redfish on the shrimp lately. By lately, I mean last couple days. So, that's what I'm gonna try. I'm gonna go throw this one out in the water, and we'll see what we catch. Okay, so I got this one set up right here. This one is on my 50-pound mono. This one I've got set up with the high-low rig. I got it primarily with shrimp. I put a little bit of squid on the tip of the hook because the shrimp can be more delicate. And I like to have a little bit of that squid that helps keep the shrimp on. And in the event that the shrimp gets nibbled off, that squid will stay on there and I'll have a little bit of bait on that hook. So I've got the high-low right here. And we've got shrimp high and low on that one. I use two different size hooks just to, you know, change things up. And then on this guy right here. And I've got that one with the 30-pound braid, and that's on the Carolina rig with a couple of big chunks of squid. So that one's out there, we're gonna see what happens. Okay, that Carolina rig was in the water maybe 1 minute, and we got a catfish. Not necessarily something you wanna keep. We're gonna toss it back, bait this up, and go back out there. That was on the upper top hook of shrimp, a little bit of squid on the Carolina rig. This is on my 50-pound mono. Got the catfish off. I put the high-low back out in the water, and literally in less than 1 minute, bam, look at this redfish. They're biting out here, guys. You've got to get out to the Texas coast. We're going to measure this guy up. This may be close to limit. I might be eating this guy. Texas redfish slot, 20 to 28 inches. This guy is 17. Toss him back. He'll grow up. We're going to catch his big brother right now. All right. A lot of people ask, well, how do you know if you have a fish on the line? Like, what's the normal action? So when you're surf fishing, your rod will naturally bend with the weight of the waves, and it's almost more rhythmic. See how it's just kind of like back and forth. Now, if there's a fish, you're gonna see jerky snaps. Oh, hello. And you'll see it'll bend and then snap and snap again. It'll really bend down. Or, your line may go completely slack. Your fish has taken your bait and swum back towards you. So that's what we're looking for here. But there's going to be some natural to and fro bending of your line while it's out in the water. Right now, I think we're seeing something playing with our line. We'll see what happens. I see some nibbles. Someone's hungry. All right, this is one of those times where it seemed like I had a fish. Did I have a fish? Did I not? Couldn't tell, couldn't feel it on the line. And it had been long enough out there, it was just time to reel it in and go double check. And sure enough, I got a little baby redfish on the line, definitely under limit. We're gonna toss him back, he'll grow up and catch him next year. So how deep am I fishing out here? How deep am I casting? Far out am I casting? I know, maybe it's, people think you gotta really get far out there. And right now, the tide's fairly low. There's a couple of different areas to fish. So I'm gonna keep riding. Oh, shoot, man. There's kind of that first little dip where the smaller waves crash. That's like the we call the trough. And there's fish in there. And then there's that first sandbar. The waves are crashing on that. And just behind that, that's your first cut. First gut, first cut, I don't know. I watch the videos. I don't even know what I'm talking about. That's where I'm picking. Then there's typically another sandbar out here on the Texas coast. And there's your second cut. And there's fish out there too. But I'm just keeping it close in. I don't know. I gotta go. I think I got the fish. All right. As fast as I can get out there, I told you guys, I'm trying to explain where I'm fishing, and the fish are interrupting my explanations.
That nice little red here.
Probably not limit. We're gonna check him out. All right. We took him over to the truck, measured him. Another 16, 17 inch, just below limit. We're gonna set him free. All right. We're gonna make sure he gets safely resuscitated and ready to go. See you later, buddy. All right, it's been an awesome morning fishing. This is gonna be my last re-up on my baits. I gotta get home. I'm a dad first. I'm just a dad. I gotta kiss my babies good morning, help mama get everyone breakfast. But man, that last redfish, he didn't even eat my bait. He's gonna cast this thing right back out there and then give me himself about 5-10 more minutes, reel it all in, go home and kiss the kids good morning. Hey, it's a beautiful day out here on the Texas coast. Jake Adams, you gotta come out here. We're having a great time. I hope you do too. All the people seeing me reel these redfish in, one after another, bam, 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 and all coming up and asking if they're whiting. And I'm like, no, I'm not whiting, they're redfish, man. And enough people have come by and see how many fish I'm catching and asked me about it. And now that I'm packing up, I'm like, what is this whiting? Yeah, they were whiting the whole time. And there's no limit. So those are all bigger fish. That was definitely a lunch or dinner of fish tacos I threw back and we should have guessed. But hey, lucky for the fish, learning experience for me. I had a great time doing it. And I hope you come down here, catch some fish, have fun in the Texas coast. This is Jake Adams signing off from Port Aransas, Texas.